Kevin's Bar Mitzvah, live from Jerusalem, Israel, January 11, 2018. Israeli calendar 5777. We're glad you are with us today.
We will be beginning with the motto Who.
The motto Who helps us to get our attitude ready before we go in to worship at the synagogue. We pause to attune ourselves to new surroundings and leave our baggage behind us. We should feel as if the area we are passing over a bridge into a new country. The Ma Tovu was first uttered by Balaam, and an outsider of Israel who nevertheless was awestruck with the glory of God of Israel. In the same way, we seek to apprehend and behold the glory of God as we make our way to worship before Him. The theme of the Ma Tovu is expressing our appreciation for being able to come together and worship in a Maha Kadosh, or a holy place.
Matovu olecha Yaakov mishkanotecha Yisrael. Veni barov chastecha avo veitecha. Esh tachave el chechel kashecha b'yiratecha. Adonai ahavti meon veitecha umkom Mishkan Kodacha Vani Eshtachave Veachra'a Evracha Lifne Adonai Osi Vani Tefila Ti Lecha Adonai Et Ratzon Elohim Baruch Hasachan Aneni Be'emet Yishencha.
How godly are your tents, Jacob, your dwelling places, Israel. As for me, through your abundant guidance, kindness, I will ever turn your house. I will prostrate myself toward your holy sanctuary in awe of you, O Lord. I love the house where you dwell, and the place where your glory tabernacles. I shall prostrate myself and bow. I shall kneel before the Lord my Maker. As for me, may my prayer to you, Lord, be at a favorable time, O God. In your abundant kindness, answer me with the truth of your salvation.
Now we are going to do the Adon Olam.
Adon Olam, Asher Malach. B'Terem Kol, Yetzir Nivra. V'yein Nasa, V'chesu Kol. Shimoni Gra. Adon Olam, Asher Malach, B'Terem Kol, Yetzir Nivra.
Adon Olam,
Li'ein Asah V'Chatzo Kol, Asai Melech, Shimoni Gra.
Adon Olam,
V'Acharei Kiklot Hakol, Levado Yimloch Nora.
Adon Olam,
V'Hu Haya V'Hu Hove, V'Hu Yiyeh V'Tifara. V'Hu
Adon Olam,
V'im Rechi Gevi Ati.
disciples' prayer.
Avinu shebashamayim yitkadesh shimcha.
Our Father, who is in heaven, sanctify your name.
Tavol malchutecha yaseh ratzoncha.
Your kingdom come, your will be done.
Ba'aretz ka'asher na'asa v'shamayim.
On earth as it is done in heaven.
Ten lanu hayom lechem chukenu.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Our portion.
Uslach lanu et ashmatenu. Ka'asher solchim anachnu la'asher ashmu lanu.
And forgive us our offenses as we forgive those who offend us.
Va'al tfianu lidei masa.
And do not lead us into the temptation.
Ki im hatzilenu min hara.
But deliver us from evil.
Ki lacha amam lacha v'hagvura. Bahat feret leolame olmaya. Amen.
For to you is the kingdom and the power and the beauty forever into the ages. Amen.
Baruch et Adonai Hamora. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam shehechayanu v'kimanu v'hegiyanu l'zman hazeh.
Our praise to you, eternal God, sovereign of all, for giving us life, sustaining us, and enabling us to reach this season.
Amen.
Honoring God's holidays. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natan lanu chagim chukot ומאוד אדים לשמחה לכבוד ישוע המשיח אדוננו אור העולם.
Blessed art thou, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who has given us holidays, customs, and seasons of happiness, for the glory of our Lord Yeshua the Messiah, the light of the world.
Blessings in Messiah. Baruch Hu Baruch Hu HaElohim Avi Adonenu Yeshua HaMashiach Asher Barach Otanu Mishmei Meono Bechol Birkat HaNefesh BaMashiach.
Blessed be to the God our Father of our Lord Yeshua the Messiah, who has blessed us in the Messiah with every spiritual blessing in heaven.
Prayer. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher kidshanu b'mitzvotav v'tzitzit lehitatef v'tzitzit.
Evan was just putting on his tallis, and this is the translation of what he was saying underneath. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who has sanctified us with his commandments and commanded us to unwrap ourselves in tzitzit. How precious is your kindness, O God. The children of men take refuge in the shadow of your wings. They shall be satiated with the delight of your house, and you will give them to drink from the river of your bliss. For with you is the source of life. In your light we see our life. Bestow your kindness upon those who know you, and your righteousness of the upright in heart.
Yotzer Hamerot.
The Yotzer Hamerot is a blessing often recited before the declaration of the Shema. During the morning service, this blessing corresponds to the Ma'ariv Aravim blessing recited before the Ma'ariv Shema declaration. A abbreviated version of the blessing is provided in your program.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam yotzer or uvorei choshech osei shalom uvorei et hakol. Baruch ata Adonai yotzer hamerot.
Blessed are you, O Lord our God, Master of the universe, who forms light and creates darkness, who makes peace and creates all things. Blessed art thou, O Lord our God.
Berachot HaShachar. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Asher Natan Lam Shebi'inam Le'achrir Bein Yom U'Bein Laila. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam She'asani Yisrael. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam She'lo Asani. Amen. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam She'asani Le'Chamo. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Pokeach Ivrim. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Mavishalumim. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Matir Asurim. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Zoker Kifufim. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Rokeh HaRen Sal HaMayim. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Shesani Kol Sorkim. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam HaMichim Mitzvah Gaber. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Ozer Yisrael Bikura. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Ozer Yisrael Tifara. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Ha'otem Mariam Efkoa. Baruch Atam Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam Ha'ter Yitzaret Ha'adam B'chachma U'varavo Nikavim Nikavim Chalulim Chalulim Gelui Ve'yadua Lifnei Chesed Chivodech Hashem Yipateach Ha'echad Mehem O Yisatem Echad Mehem Yashar Le'kayem Le'kayem. la'amod lefanecha baruch atah Adonai rofei chobasar umafli la'asot.
Blessed are you, Lord our God, Master of the universe, who fashioned mankind in wisdom and created in him all manner of openings and cavities. It is manifest and known before the throne of your glory that if any one of them ruptured or were blocked, it would be impossible to survive and stand before you. Blessed are you, O Lord, who heals all flesh and is wonderful in his acts.
Now we are doing the Yom Yom Yamos Lanu.
In the following blessing taken from Scripture, the phrase Yom Yom Yamos Lanu can be translated as who daily carries our burden for us. Just as a humble pack animal might bear heavy sacks of grain for its owner, or a beast of burden might suffer the drag of a plow in a field, so God, in his infinite compassion, bears our burden in order to lift us up and relieves our distress so that we can walk uprightly before him.
Baruch Adonai Yom Yom Ya'amos Lanu Ha'el Yeshuatenu Selah.
Blessed be the Lord, who daily carries our burden, the God of our salvation, Salah. Jesus' Hebrew name is Yeshua, which comes from the same root, Yasha, as Yeshuatenu. In this verse, Ha-O-El, Yeshuatenu means the God of our Yeshua, salvation, and points to the salvation given to us through Jesus as the sin-bearer before the Father. Every day, Jesus carries the burden of our sins so that we might bear the burden of his love for others. Baruch Shem Kevodo Leolam. Blessed be his glorious name forever.
Kaddish. Kaddish.
The Kaddish is an ancient prayer of praise written in Aramaic that expresses the longing for the establishment of God's kingdom on earth. Originally recited by rabbis when they had finished giving their sermons, the Rabbi Kaddish. In time, the prayer was modified and became associated with mourning. The words of the Kaddish provide lasting comfort by stressing the greatness and sovereignty of God, even the most harrowing of life's circumstances. The word Kaddish means sanctification, referring to the hallowing of God's name, Kiddush Hashem.
Amen. Alma di bara chirute v'yamlich malchute v'chayechon uv'yomechon uv'chaye dechol beit Yisrael ba'agala uv'yisman kariv v'imr. Amen.
Amen. Yehe shemei rabba mevara le'alam u'almei u'almaya.
Yehe shmei rabba mevarach le'olam ulalmei almaya. Yitbarach v'yishtabach v'yitba'ar v'yitromam v'yitnaseh v'yithadar v'yitale v'yitalal shmei dekudasha. Barichu.
Barichu.
Le'la min kol birchata v'shirata tushbechata v'nechemata da'amiran be'alma ve'imru. Amen.
Amen.
Shehakol nehaya.
For by him all things were created in heaven and on earth, visible and invisible, whether thrones or dominions or rulers or authorities, all things were created through him and for him.
Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam shehakol neya bedvaro shehakol bara lechvodo shetamid zocher brito shecho male haolam b'shem uvadam Yeshua Mashiachenu. Amen.
Amen.
Blessed art you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who brings about everything by his word, who creates all for his glory, who always remembers his covenant, whose power fills the universe, in the name and blood of Jesus our Messiah. Amen.
Amen.
The Olam Yehei Adam.
The Le'olam portion of the Shacharit service prepares the heart for the recitation of the Shema, the most significant declaration of the unity of God in the Jewish liturgy. This prayer is made up of excerpts from the Bible, the Talmud, and was compiled in about 456 CE when a Persian ruler forbade Babylonian Jews to read the Shema publicly.
Le'olam Yehei Adam Yirei Shemayim B'Seter U'Vagalui U'Modei Al Ha'emet V'Dover Emet B'Lvavo V'Yashkem V'Yomer Ribon Kol Ha'olamim Lo Al Ha'tzidkotenu Anachnu Mafilim Tachanu Tenenu Lefanecha Ki Al Rachamecha Harabim Ma Anachnu Mechayenu Ma Chasdenu Ma Tzidkotenu Ma Yeshua Tenu Ma Kochenu Ma Gura Tenu Ma Gomar Lifanecha Adonai Elohim Velo He Avotenu.
At all times should a man fear God publicly and privately and attest to the truth, speaking the truth within his heart, and rise up early and say, Master of all worlds, not of our own righteousness do we cast our supplications before you, but because of your great mercy. Who are we? What is our life? What is our kindness? What is our righteousness? What is our salvation? What is our strength? What is our might? What can we say before you, Lord our God, and the glory of our fathers? Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Of all the various barahoth, this is one of the most important of all, since we come to be in a right relationship with Yahweh, the Father of glory, by means of salvation through Yeshua the Messiah. This simple Hebrew blessing expresses our thanks to the Lord for the way salvation given through Yeshua the Messiah.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam asher natamanu et derech ha-Yeshua b'Mashiach Yeshua. Baruch Hu. Amen.
Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who gave us the way of salvation through the Messiah Yeshua. Blessed be he. Amen.
Praising God's sovereignty.
I am the Lord, and there is no other. I form light and create darkness. I make peace and I create evil. I am the Lord. Who does all these things? Yeshua is indeed the Messiah, the Good Shepherd who always did what the Father delighted in. He is the one who rebuilds a temple made without hands and is the true foundation stone of all everlasting praise to God. Blessed be he.
Baruch ata Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam yotzer or uvorei osei shalom uvorei et hakol.
Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who forms light and creates darkness, who makes peace and creates all things.
Deshma.
The Shema is the central prayer in the Jewish prayer book, or the Siddur, and is often the first section of scripture that a Jewish child learns. During its recitation in the synagogue, Orthodox Jews pronounce each word very carefully and cover their eyes with their right hand. Many Jews recite the Shema at least twice daily, once in the morning and once in the evening. It is also sometimes said as a bedtime prayer. The Shema is actually more than just a famous six words Shema Yisrael Adonai Eloheinu Adonai Echad, but it's composed of three parts. It's the Shema from Deuteronomy, the Vehaya, the Valamir. Those three parts entail the Shema.
The Shema.
Shema.
And you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your might. And these words that I command you today shall be in your heart. And you shall teach them diligently to your children, and you shall speak of them when you sit at home, and when you walk along the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise up. And you shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and they shall be the frontlets between your eyes, and you shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. So you shall put these, my words, in your heart and in your soul. And you shall bind them for signs on your hands, and they shall be for frontlets between your eyes. And you shall teach them to your children, and you shall speak of them when you sit at home, and when you walk along the way, and when you lie down, and when you rise up. And you shall write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates, in order to prolong your days and the days of your children on the land that the Lord promised your forefathers that he would give them, as long as the days of heavens are over the earth.
Part 2, Deuteronomy 11, 13 to 21. Veheya im shamoa tishmu el mitzvotai. Part 2, Deuteronomy 11, 13 to 21.
The second part of the Shema repeats many of the themes from the first part, but it has promises of rewards and punishments.
V'heya im shamoa tishmu el mitzvotai.
And it shall come to pass, if you truly listen to the commandments,
asher anochi mitzaveh etchem hayom,
that I command you today,
le'ahava et Adonai Elohechem ulavdo b'chol levavchem u'chol nafshechem,
to love the Lord your God and to serve him with all of your heart and all of your soul.
V'natati matar artschem be'ito yoreh u'malkosh v'asaf ta deganecha v'tiroshcha v'yitz arecha.
Then I will give you rain to your land, the early and the late rains, that you may gather in your grain, your wine, and your oil.
V'natati esev v'sadcha levchemtecha v'achalta v'sarvata.
And I will give grass in your fields for your cattle, and you will eat and you will be satisfied.
Hishmaru lechem hen yifteh levavchem v'sartem v'avadtem Elohim acharim v'ishtachavitem lechem.
Beware lest your heart be deceived, and you turn and serve other gods and worship them.
V'chara af Adonai v'chem v'atzar et ha-shamimayim v'lo yehe matar v'adama lo titen et yivulah.
And anger of the Lord will blaze against you, and he will close the heavens, and there will not be rain, and the earth will not give you its fullness.
Ve'avadtem mehera me'al ha'aretz ha'tova asher Adonai noten lechem.
And you will perish quickly from the good land that the Lord gives you. This prayer begins with the song that the Israelites sang after crossing through the Red Sea.
Oh, no. Yifat Adonai et Yaakov. Bung Yalom Yad Chazak Mimenu. Baruch
forward, then three steps back as we approach in prayer. So, one, two, three. One, two, three. Forever. You are the reviver of the dead. You are greatly able to save. You sustain the living in loving kindness. You revive the dead with great compassion. You support the fallen, heal the sick, set free the bound, and keep faith with those who sleep in the dust. Who is like you, O Master of mighty deeds, who compares to you a king who puts to death and restores to life and brings forth salvation, and you are faithful to revive the dead. Blessed art thou, O Lord, our God, who revives the dead.
Kedushat Hashem.
The third blessing of the weekday Amidah is called Kedushat Hashem, the holiness of the name. Kedushat Hashem is also a technical term for sanctifying God's name, which in extreme cases may require the giving of your life. The following is recited when you are by yourself reciting the Amidah.
Atah kadosh v'shimcha kadosh u'kdoshim b'chol yom yehalucha selah baruch atah Adonai ha'el ha'kadosh.
You are holy and your name is holy, and your holy ones praise you every day. Blessed are you, Adonai, the God who is holy. This is with a minion reading. We will sanctify your name in this world, just as it's sanctified in the highest heavens, as it is written by your prophet, and they shall call to one another and say,
Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory.
And those facing them praise God, saying,
Blessed be the presence of the Lord in his place.
And in your holy word it is written, saying,
The Lord reigns forever, your God is Zion, throughout all generations, hallelujah.
Throughout all generations we will declare your greatness, and to all eternity we will proclaim your holiness. Your praise, our God, shall never depart from our mouth, for you are a great and holy God and King. Blessed are you, O Lord, the holy God. You are holy and your name is holy. And the holy ones praise you daily. Blessed are you, Adonai, the God who is holy.
Da'at.
The fourth blessing of the weekday Amidah is called the Da'at, or knowledge, and functions as a prayer for understanding from the Lord. Note that this part of the Amidah is only recited during weekdays. The Shabbat and holy versions skip this prayer.
Atah honen le'adam da'at u'lamed le'enosh bina chanenu me'itcha de'a bina ve'hezkel baruch atah Adonai honen hada'at.
Show your favor to a man of knowledge, and you teach understanding to a mortal man. Be gracious to us. A mind of understanding and intellect is from you. Blessed are you, Adonai, who favors us with knowledge.
Teshuvah.
The fifth blessing of the weekday Amidah is called the Teshuvah, or turning, and functions as a prayer for return to the Lord and His Torah. Note that this part of the Amidah is only recited during weekdays.
Hashivenu avinu letoratecha lekarvenu malchkenu leavodatecha v'hachazirenu b'tshuva shlema Necha baruch atah Adonai haroseh v'tshuvah.
Return us, our Father, to your Torah. Draw us near to our King to serve you. Restore us to your presence in complete repentance. Blessed art you, O Lord our God, who desires repentance.
Slicha.
The sixth blessing in the week, the Amidah, is called Slicha, forgiveness, and functions as a confession of sin before the Lord. This is only recited during weekdays.
Slach lanu avinu ki chatanu machal lanu malkenu ki pashanu ki mochel v'soleach ata baruch ata Adonai chanun hamarbe lasloach.
Forgive us, our Father, for we have sinned. Pardon us, our King, for we have rebelled. For you are a pardoner and a forgiver. Blessed are you, O Lord, the gracious one who abundantly forgives.
Now,
the seventh blessing of the week, Day Amidah, is called Geulah, redemption, and appeals to the Lord for redemption and deliverance. The Talmud states that this blessing, positioned as seventh in the Amidah, points to the future advent of the Messiah, which will be presided by 7 years of travail, the time of Jacob's trouble. In the seventh year, the upheaval will reach its climatic stage and the world will totter on the brink of total destruction. Then the Messiah will appear and the end horror to usher in an era of unsurpassed shalom.
Rei venenu v'riva rivenu ugalenu mehera lema'an shmecha ki goel chazak ata baruch ata Adonai goel Yisrael.
Behold our affliction and champion our cause and redeem us speedily for the sake of thy name. Blessed art thou, O Lord, our God, Redeemer of Israel.
Refuah.
The Refuah, healing, is the eighth blessing of the Amidah, wherein an appeal is made to the Lord as a faithful and compassionate healer.
Refa'enu Adonai v'nerafet Hoshienu v'nivasha'a ki tehilatechnu ata v'ha'ale refua shlema l'chol matotenu ki el melech rofe ne'eman Rachaman ata baruch ata Adonai rofe chole amo Yisrael.
Heal us, O Lord, and we shall be healed. Save us, and we will be saved. For the one we praise is you. Bring complete healing for all our sicknesses. For, O God, for you are our faithful and compassionate healer and King. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, the healer of the sick of Israel.
Berchat HaShanim. Berchat HaShanim.
The Berchat HaShanim, blessing of the years, is the ninth blessing of the Amidah, wherein appeal is made to the Lord to prosper us for the year's needs.
Barach Eleinu Adonai Elohim et HaShanah Hazot Ve'et Kol Minei Tfuatah Letova v'ten bracha al pnei ha'adama v'shabenu mituvecha uvarech shnatenu kashanim hatovot baruch ata Adonai mevarech hashanim.
Blessed us, Adonai, our God, this year and its crops. Grant us blessing for the earth. Satisfy us from the bounty and bless our year like other good years. Blessed art thou, O Lord our God, who blesses the years.
Kibbutz Galiot.
The Kibbutz Galiot, gathering of exiles, is the tenth blessing of the Amidah, where an appeal is made to the Lord to return the Jews from the affliction of Galot.
Tekka v'shofar gadol l'cherutenu v'sa nes l'kabetz galuyotenu v'kabtsenu yachad me'arba kanfot ha'aretz baruch ata Adonai mekabetz Nidche Amo Yisrael.
Sound the great shofar for our freedom, and raise a banner to gather our exiles and unite us together from the four corners of the earth. Blessed art thou, our Lord our God, who regathers the scattered of his people, Israel.
Birchat Hadin.
The Birchat Hadin, restoration of justice, is the 11th blessing of the Amidah, where an appeal is made to the Lord to restore righteous rule upon the earth.
Hashiba Shoftenu Kevarishona Vayoatzenu Kvat Chila Vechaser Mimenu Yagon Ven Anacha Umbloch Alenu Atadonai Levadvadcha Bechesed Ubrachamim Betzadkenu Bamishpat Baruch Ata Adonai Melech Ohev Tzadak Umishpat.
Restore our judges as in the early times, and advisors as there once were. Remove our sorrows and troubles. We want you, Adonai, to rule over us with kindness and compassion, and to justify us in justice. Blessed art you, O Lord our God, the King who loves righteousness and justice.
Benyan Yerushalayim.
This is the 12th blessing against heretics.
Berchat Taminim.
This is the 12th blessing against heretics.
Velamal Shimim Al Tehi Tekva Vechol Harisha Krega Tovad Vechol Oivecha Mehera Ke Yekaretu Vehazedin Nehera ta'aker utshaber utmager v'tach giyah bimhera v'yamenu baruch atah Adonai shover oivim umachnia sedim.
And for slanderers, let there be no hope, and may all the evil in an instant be destroyed, and all thy enemies be cut down swiftly, and the evil ones uproot and break and destroy and humble soon in our ways. Blessed are you, our God, who breaks down enemies and humbles sinners.
Tzadikim.
The 13th blessing of the Amidah is called Tzadikim, or righteous ones, and is an appeal to the Lord to show compassion and grace toward the righteous.
Al ha-tzadikim ba'al ha-chasidim ba'al ziknei amcha beit Yisrael ba'al platat sofrehem ba'al gerei ha-tzedek ve'alenu yehemu rachav mecha Adonai Eloheinu V'ten Shachar Tov L'chor Habotchim B'Shimcha Be'emet V'sim Chelkenu Imachem Le'olam V'lo Nevosh Ki V'cha B'tachnu Baruch Atah Adonai Mishan Yevumivtach Letzadikim.
Upon the righteous, upon the pious, upon the elders of your people in the house of Israel, upon the remnant of your scholars, upon the righteous converts, and upon ourselves, may your compassion arise, O Lord our God, and give good reward to all who sincerely believe in your name. Include us with them forever, and do not let us be ashamed, for we put our trust in you. Blessed art thou, O Lord our God, the stronghold and assurance of the righteous.
and Yom Yerushalayim.
This is the 14th blessing, rebuilding Jerusalem. While Gaviot exile, the Jews never stopped mourning for and praying to return to Jerusalem. This sentiment finds its expression in Zionism, the worldwide movement of the Jewish people to return to their ancient homeland as the chosen people of God. In fact, the Amidah prayer itself, that quintessential prayer recited three times a day by Orthodox Jews, is recited facing to the east toward Jerusalem. The 14th blessing of the Amidah is called Binyan Yerushalayim, rebuilding of Jerusalem, expresses the Jewish dream of being restored to rebuild the city of Jerusalem as the city of David and the city of the Lord on the earth.
The Yerushalayim, Yerucha, Berachamim, Teshuv, V'tach, V'tashkon, B'chukha, Ka'asher, Dibarta, Uvnei Ota, B'karov, B'yamenu, Binyan Olam, B'chisei David, Mehera, Letocha, Tzachim, Baruch Ata Adonai, Bonei Yisrael.
Return in compassion to your city, Jerusalem, and rest within it as you have said. Rebuild it specifically and in ways a sanctuary structure forever. And may you establish the throne of David within Jerusalem speedily. Blessed art thou, O Lord our God, the rebuilder of Jerusalem.
Malchut Beit David.
The Kingdom of David. Blessings 10 through 15 of the Amidah emphasize the Lord's redemption of natural Israel. With blessing 15, Malchut Beit David, the appeal is made for the branch of David to arise and bring about Israel's salvation through Yeshua. We believe that Yeshua HaTzarek, Jesus of Nazareth, is indeed the promised and only legitimate Jewish Messiah, revealed both as Yeshua ben Yosef and Yeshua ben David. As Yeshua ben Joseph, he perfectly fulfilled the role of the suffering servant and Hagoel, Redeemer of national Israel. As Yeshua ben David, he will come again to set up the Davidic kingdom and reign on earth from Jerusalem. As Messianic Jews, we pray that the soon coming of the true, the Tamak David, revealed as Yeshua HaMashiach, to set up his kingdom speedily and in our days.
Tzemach David, Avdecha, Nehera, Tatzmiach, Vekarno, Tarum, Mishua, Techa, Kile, Shua, Tcha, Kevineu, Kol Hayom, Baruch, Ata, Adonai, Masmiach, Keren, Yeshua.
May the seed of David, thy servant, flourish speedily, and may you exalt in your salvation. For in your salvation do we hope all the day. Blessed art you, O Lord our God, who brings forth the horn of our salvation.
Kabbalat Tefillah.
Blessing 16 of the Amidah prayer, Kabbalat Tefillah, is an appeal to the Lord for pity, mercy, and acceptance of the foregoing petitions, and thereby closes the petitionary middle section of the foregoing sequence of prayers.
Shema kolenu Adonai Eloheinu, chus verachem alenu vekabel rachamim uvratzon et tefillatenu ki el shomea tefiloch v'tachanunim ata. Umilfanecha malkenu rekam al tishibenu ki eta shomea tefillat amcha Yisrael barachamim baruch ata Adonai shomei ha-tefillat.
Hear our voice, O Lord our God, and have pity and mercy upon us, and accept in mercy and in favor our prayer. For you are a God who hears prayers and supplications. Do not turn us away from before you are empty, for you empty. For in mercy you hear the prayer of your people Israel. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, who hears our prayers.
Avodah.
The Avodah, worship, is the 17th blessing on the weekday Amidah and the 5th blessing of the Shavuot Amidah. According to the rabbis of the Talmud, the Avodah prayer was said by the priests of the temple just after they offered the sacrifices.
Say Adonai Eloheinu be'amcha Yisrael uvit filat. Tam bechashev et ha'avodah levir betecha ve'ishe Yisrael utfilat tam ve'ahava tekabel baratzon ut hin leratzon tamid avodat Yisrael amcha ve'techezehna einenu v'shucha le'zion barachamim baruch ata Adonai hamachazir shechinato le'zion.
Accept your people, O Lord our God, and receive their prayer. Restore the most holy service of your house and accept the love and offerings and prayers of Israel. May it please you always to want to accept the service of your people, Israel. May our eyes see you and return to Zion in mercy. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, who restores his presence to Zion. The 18th blessing of the weekday Amidah is composed of two parts, the Hadoah portion, expressing thanks to the Lord, and the concluding section, Hadoah, means gratitude, and is considered the most basic of attitudes toward Hashem.
Modim anachnu lach she'ata hu Adonai Eloheinu ve'elohei avoteinu le'olam va'ed. Tzur chayeinu magen yeshenu ata hu l'dor v'dor. Node lecha unsaper tehilatecha al chayeinu hamsurim bayadecha ba'al nishmotenu ha'kodot lach ba'al nisecha shekhol yom imanu ba'al niflotecha v'tovotecha shekhol et erev v'boker v'tzoharayim hatov ki lo chalu rachamecha v'chamrachem ki lo tamu chasadecha me'elom kivienu lachat.
We thank you, for it is you alone who is Adonai our God and the God of our fathers forever and ever. You are the rock and shield of our salvation, you alone from generation to generation. We thank you and tell of your praise, for our lives are in your hands and our souls are trusting in you. Every day your miracles are within us. Your wonders and favors are at all times, evening, morning, and afternoon. O good one, your compassions are never exhausted and your kindness is continual. We put our hope in you. The final blessing of the weekday Amidah is called Sim Shalom, which means create peace, and anticipates the Birkat Kohamim. May he grant you peace.
Sim Shalom.
This blessing ends with the following ritual. Bow to the left for the phrase Boseh Shalom. V'merav, bow forward and during the Hashem Shalom Aleinu, and straighten up for Vayel Kol Yisrael. V'menu, Amen.
Sing Shalom Tova U'Varucha, Hen V'Chesed V'Rachamim, Aleinu V'Al Kol Yisrael Amecha, Varchenu Avinu Kulanu Ke'edad Ve'or Panecha, Ki Ve'or Panecha Netatita Lanu Adonai Eloheinu Torat Chaim Ve'ahavat Chesed U'tzedaka U'vracha V'rachamim V'chaim V'shalom V'tov B'necha Levarech Et Amcha Yisrael B'chol Et U'chol Sha'ah B'shlomecha Baruch Atah Adonai Hambarech Et Amo Yisrael V'shalom Osei Shalom B'mramav Hu Ya'aseh Shalom Aleinu V'al Kol Yisrael Ve'imra. Amen.
Grant peace, goodness, blessing, grace, kindness, and compassion upon us and upon all of your people Israel. Bless us, our Father, all of us as one, with the light of your face, with the light of your face. You give us, Adonai our God, the Torah of life and love of kindness, righteousness, blessing, compassion, life, and peace. And may it be good in your eyes to bless your people Israel at every time and in every hour with your peace. Blessed art thou, O Lord our God, who blesses his people Israel with peace. May he who makes peace in his high places make peace for us and for all of Israel, and say ye, Amen. Amen. I now invite Joe to come up and make Aliyah to the Torah with me. Blessed art you, O Lord, who giver of the Torah. Now Evan will do his Torah portion. Ishma lechem bar
English. Now it came about on the day when the Lord spoke to Moses in the land of Egypt, that the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, I am the Lord, speak to Pharaoh, king of Egypt, all that I speak to you. But Moses said before the Lord, behold, I am unskilled in speech. How then will Pharaoh listen to me? Then the Lord said to Moses, see, I make you as God to Pharaoh, and your brother Aaron shall be your prophet. You shall speak all that I command you, and your brother Aaron shall speak to Pharaoh, that he let the sons of Israel go out of his land. But I will harden Pharaoh's heart, that I may multiply my signs and wonders in the land of Egypt. When Pharaoh does not listen to you, then I will lay my hand on Egypt and bring out my hosts, my people, the sons of Israel, from the land of Egypt by great judgments. The Egyptians shall know that I am the Lord when I stretch out my hand over Egypt and bring out the sons of Israel from their midst. So Moses and Aaron did this, as the Lord commanded them. Thus they did it. Moses was 80 years old, and Aaron was 83 when they spoke to Pharaoh.
Baruch Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, asher natan lanu Torah emet v'charei olam mitam katov lanu. Baruch atah Adonai noten haTorah.
Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who gave us the Torah of truth and set everlasting life in our midst. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, giver of the Torah.
Brit Chadashah blessings.
The New Testament is called the Brit Chadashah in Hebrew, meaning the new covenant. The word Brit means covenant, Chadashah means new. Just like the Torah and the Chadashah blessings, Messianic Jewish believers thank the Lord God of Israel for the gift of the new covenant scriptures before and after the reading of them. I'd like to call Evan's grandparents Joy and Leroy to do the Aliyah for the Brit Chadashah.
Blessed art thou, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who gave us the Messiah Jesus and the commandments of the new covenant. Blessed art thou, O Lord, giver of the new covenant.
As they were going along the road, someone said to him, I will follow you wherever you go. And Jesus said to him, the foxes have holes and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. And he said to another, follow me. But he said, Lord, permit me first to go and bury my father. But he said to him, allow the dead to bury their own dead. But as for you, go and proclaim everywhere the kingdom of God. Another said, I will follow you, Lord, but first permit me to say goodbye to those at home. But Jesus said to him, no one after putting his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God.
Blessed are you, Lord our God, King of the universe, who gave to us the word of truth and planted everlasting life in our midst. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, who gave her of the new covenant.
Yirat Adonai.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of knowledge. Such an attitude of devotion yields wisdom, which is a result of practicing the presence of the Lord in our daily lives. As James tells us, this wisdom is first pure, then full of peace, gentleness, mercy, good fruits, and sincerity. Since we are created by God to worship Him and know Him, it is often recited in the morning to remind us as the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Reshit Chachma Yirat Adonai Sechel Tov Lechor Osehem Te'ilato Omedet La'at Baruch Shem Kavod Malchuto Le'olam Va'ed.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, a good understanding of all that they have to do in His commandments. His praise endures forever. Blessed be the King of His glorious kingdom forever and ever. Today is my honor, because today Evan becomes a man. Our responsibility is for his spiritual growth is now upon him. We will always be available to guide him, but his relationship with Jesus is his now and his own. I feel like when God said in Matthew 3:17, "This is my son whom I love. With him I am well pleased." I am very proud of my son as he reaches this day.
Okay, so I would like to open my sermon in prayer, so please bow your heads. Dear God, thank you for this marvelous opportunity to come to Israel, to do my bar mitzvah, walk where your son walked. I pray that you give me wisdom and understanding in my spiritual journey, and give everyone else wisdom and understanding in theirs. Amen. Okay, Hayom Ani Ish, today I am a man. As you know, this is quite an important moment in the life of a Jewish man or woman. But by being bar mitzvahed, I am officially through the stage of childhood and entering into my manhood. Before you are bar mitzvahed in a Jewish community, you are under the direction and instruction of your parents. But once you have been bar mitzvahed, you accept your responsibility of being a man, of being the main contributor to your spiritual and physical state. Your parents are still involved in this, of course. They will still take care of you until you grow up physically, but they are more partners in this walk, and we do this together. They never really had full control, because that belongs to God, obviously. This is a big responsibility for me to have to take care of myself in my journey through maturity. I accept this responsibility willingly and pray that I do not abuse it, but use it for God's glory. If you want, you can turn to Exodus 6:28, 7-7 in your Bibles. Basically, what happens in this chapter is God is telling Moses to speak his message to Pharaoh, to speak God's message to Pharaoh, let my people go. I want to tell them to go to Israel, okay? But Moses says that I can speak to Pharaoh. I just can't do it. I'm not eloquent enough. Sounds a lot like what some of us would do when asked to preach. But God, I just can't preach. I'm not a good public speaker. Then God says to Moses that he has made him like God to Pharaoh, and that he will appoint his brother Aaron to be his prophet. Why did Aaron get the role of speaking to Pharaoh when God had just asked Moses the previous verse to do this exact job? Here is the thing. God was angry with Moses because he made a petty excuse not to do his God-given calling. Moses directed the whole nation of Israel for about 40 years after that. I don't think he was really an eloquent. Probably not a good chance. To be a leader, you have to be eloquent. what he was really saying is, God, I don't want to do it. Do I have to? Do I have to? Do I really have to? According to J. Vernon McGee, this is why God gave Aaron the job instead of Moses, because Aaron was afraid and thought of himself more than God's mission for him. Then God goes on to say, You are to say everything that I command you to say to Pharaoh, but I will harden his heart and do great wonders, but he will not listen to you. And I will bring out my divisions, my people, the Israelites, and the Egyptians will know that I am the Lord when I stretch out my hand against Egypt and bring the Israelites out of it. I want to make clear that when God says he will harden Pharaoh's heart, he isn't just making this peaceful, flower-loving, gracious Pharaoh refuse to let them go to Israel. Before God hardened Pharaoh's heart, Pharaoh was a corrupt, evil, power-hungry, abusive ruler. He kept the Israelites in slavery for decades, before Moses took them away in a mass exodus, and before God said he would harden Pharaoh's heart. What God means by saying that he's going to harden Pharaoh's heart is that he will make known how corrupt Pharaoh's heart really was. He will reveal what was already hidden in this corrupt Pharaoh. Now you may turn to Luke 9, verses 57 to 62. What is happening here in this chapter is that Jesus is meeting people on his journeys who want to follow him, but not with all of their heart. In verses 57 and 58 it says, and as they were going along the road, someone said to him, I will follow you wherever you go. But Jesus replied to him, the foxes have holes and the birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. This first person is what has been called the comfortable disciple, the person who is willing to serve God so long as it is only comfortable to him, as long as it doesn't bring him discomfort by leaving his ordinary circumstances, by leaving his comfortable circumstances. Going on, we read, and he said to another, follow me. But he said, the person talking to Jesus said, permit me first to go and bury my father. But he said to him, allow the dead to bury their own dead, but as for you, go and proclaim everywhere the kingdom of God. This is what has been called the convenient disciple, the man who is willing to serve God only when it is convenient for his circumstances and himself. We see in this passage that the man requests to be permitted to bury his... Hold on. We see in this passage that the man requests to be permitted to bury his dead father. When he asks, Jesus refuses him to bury his father if he wants to go with Jesus. Why has Jesus refused these disciples to follow him? Because he knows they will only follow him until it proves inconvenient or uncomfortable for them, at which point they will probably leave and go back to their own devices of comfort and convenience. Finally, in verses 9, 61 to 62, we read, and another also said, I will follow you, Lord, but first permit me to say goodbye to those at home. But Jesus said to him, no one after putting his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. This man is the distracted disciple. He follows Jesus only if there are no distractions. Looking at this passage, we may think this is a bit silly that Jesus is refusing these people 5 minutes to get their ends in order before they leave. Maybe it'll take a day at most to bury the guy's father, take half an hour to say goodbye to his family. It's not a horrible time waster. But is that really all they want? After a few weeks of ministry with Jesus, they would have gone back to their lives because they had something important to take care of, or they got this uncomfortable in persecution from the Pharisees, or possibly because it was inconvenient for them to have to travel so much and they wanted to go settle down. We might say something like, I would never be that dumb to leave God for an everyday distraction. Nope. That's not me at all. These people are just fools. How can this apply to me? But when we look truly at ourselves, at our lives, isn't that just what we do? We always want comfort or convenience, or we may go off chasing worldly distractions. I think we all do this multiple times a day, sometimes without even realizing it. We put off reading your Bibles, or going to church, or talking to God in prayer for a seemingly good reason, but the real reason is going to be one of the three: distraction, convenience, or comfort. God wants us to put Him first before these things. So I would like to ask you a question. Which of the three are you? Distraction, television, music, etc. Convenience, time, priorities, too far to go, out of your way. I don't have my tithe with me. I don't want to stop what I'm doing, etc. Or comfort, sleep, food, entertainment, addiction, other relationships than Christ, etc. You may be wondering, how does the story with Jesus relate to a story to Moses, who lived 3,000 years ago, before Jesus? Well, not quite 3,000, maybe 2 or 3, just generalize. The relationship is that in both situations, God is dealing with excuse makers. From the passage, I judge Moses to be the convenient, comfort type of excuse maker. Here is a simple test to judge whether that is a correct statement. Simply put the name of the person, of the suspected person, into one of their state. Simply put the name of the type of the selected person into one of their statement, into one of their excuses. God, it is not comfortable for me to speak to Pharaoh when I'm ineloquent. I can't do it. It's uncomfortable for me to do this. It's difficult. This seems to make the most sense. What is interesting is that God, even though he took away from Moses the power to give God's message himself, he still gave Moses a prominent part in the Exodus from Egypt. Why God did this for Moses, who didn't really want to help, and not the people on the road, who in a small way did want to help God, I don't know. God is God, so he is big enough to make his own decisions. Possibly, he saw something in Moses that he knew was what God wanted to do as well. Possibly, Jesus saw something in those travelers who wanted to make him who wanted to help him, that he knew he really didn't want them to serve him. Possibly the travelers in the New Testament were lying to him because they really wanted things from him. He's God. They were trying to sucker him, get close to him, and get free merchandise or whatever. Free scriptural advice. They didn't really want to help him. Maybe. But I do know one thing. Both of these passages, people in both of these passages are putting themselves in front of God's plan. God wants us to put His plan first in our lives. But they both put off His greater plan by making excuses. So, how then shall we live? Number one, priorities. We need to make God the main priority in our lives. As we see in both of these passages, there are consequences when you make excuses not to follow God. God will make our task possible if we only agree to do it. God would have absolutely made Moses the most eloquent speaker of the time if he really even needed it. If Moses had agreed to be obedient to God's plan, he would have done it. Number two, replace our excuses with God's word. Number A, comfort. We should be willing to go outside of our comfort zones. We should be willing to read God's word honestly and unbiased. Even when there is something in there that disagrees with what you believe to be right or true, don't just pass over that passage and say it was a translation error, it was written down wrong in the first place. But first examine your belief that contradicts the scripture. You may be surprised by what you find. B, convenience. This is a hard one for a lot of people. We tend to put off prayer at night because we're too tired, or reading our Bibles in the morning because we want to watch TV instead, or not go to church because we're too tired and need our rest. We should be willing to put off our comfort and spend that whatever amount of time you need to praying at night, the half hour reading our Bibles in the morning and praying, and the hour and a half or so going to church to praise the God who created us. He deserves all of our 24 hours a week, every day, so He's being gracious, only making us give an hour and a half, only asking us to give an hour and a half. See, distraction. We have to pay attention to God. Distractions are from the devil. See Matthew 4, 1 through 11, where the devil uses distractions to tempt Jesus in the desert. He distracts him when he was hungry. Yes. He said, I'll make you king of all the cities of the world. He was distracting him with all that stuff. 1 Timothy 6:9. Those who want to get rich fall into temptation and a trap, and into many foolish and harmful desires that plunge people into destruction and ruin. They were distracted from God by wanting to be rich instead of finding Him. We can hear God in stillness and quiet. Psalm 46:10. Be still and know that I am God. So Satan's main goal is to distract us with noise and entertainment, pompous and extravagance, so that we can't even hear God's voice. We need to hear God's voice if we want to carry out His plans. Three. Obedience to God's plan is beneficial for us. God doesn't need our help. However, when we are obedient to God's plan, He is a good God and will give us His mercy. He will still give us His mercy if we do not. But when we skip out on God's plans, however, we are missing some very monumental opportunities that God had planned for us. We could have, if you skip out on a missionary trip, you miss hearing all the great stories and preaching to people in other countries. It's a great opportunity. God can find someone else, but you push yourself farther from God every time we refuse to be obedient to His plans for our lives. Think about all the opportunities we have missed by putting off God's plans for our meager excuses. I would like to close in prayer. Dear God, help us to be more, help us to get our priorities in order. Help us to put You first in our lives and to be willing to get rid of our excuses and help us to replace our excuses with Your word so that we can help those out who are like us in our excuses. And help us to be obedient to Your plan for us. We know that when we do Your plan, You're not going to punish us for helping You, but You are going to reward us in heaven. And I thank You for that. Amen.
Just for FYI, Evan wrote that himself, and other than a couple of grammatical changes, this entire thing was Evan's sermon. We had nothing to do with it, so thank you, Evan. It is customary to recite the blessing for Jerusalem before the Torah is read, which we did during the service, though praying for the welfare of Jerusalem is always an appeal of the Ruach HaKodesh, the Holy Spirit.
Av harachamim heitiba v'rtzoncha et ritzon. Tevne chomot Yerushalayim ki becha levad tabachnu melech el ram v'nisa adon olami.
Father of mercies, do good in thy good pleasure unto Zion. Build thou the walls of Jerusalem. For in You alone do we trust, O King, God exalted and uplifted, Master of the universe.
Pray for peace of Jerusalem.
As believers in the Messiah Yeshua, we understand that Jerusalem is near and dear to the Lord God of Israel, and we take heed the commandment given in the Scriptures to pray for the peace of Jerusalem.
Shalom, shalom, Yerushalayim, Yeshayui, Ohavich.
Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. May they prosper who love You.
Kaddish.
Exalted and hallowed God. Oh, you need to read that first. Say it again. 3, 2, 1.
Yitgadol v'yitgadash shem rabbah. Amen. Yehei Shnei Rabba Mevarach Le'olam Ulamei Amaya. Yitbarach, V'yishtahach, V'yitpa'ar, V'yitromam, V'yitnaseh, V'yithadar, V'yitala, V'yithalal, Shnei Dekudasha, Rechu, Le'era, Min Kol, Birchata, V'shirata, Tushbachata, V'nechemata, Da'amiran, Be'alma, V'imru, Amen. Yehe Shlama Rabba Min Shamaya Vechaim Aleinu Ve'al Kol Yisrael Ve'imru
Amen.
Yose Shalom Be'mromal Uya Hase Shalom Aleinu Ve'al Kol Yisrael Ve'imru
Amen.
Exalted and hallowed be God's great name in the world which God created, according to plan. May God's majesty be revealed in the days of our lifetime and the life of all Israel, speedily, imminently, to which we say, Amen. Blessed be God's great name to all eternity. Blessed, praised, honored, exalted, extolled, glorified, adored, and lauded be the name of the Holy Blessed One, beyond all earthly worlds and songs of blessing, praise, and comfort, to which we say, Amen. May there be abundant peace from heaven and life for us and all of Israel, to which we say,
Amen.
May the one who creates harmony on high bring peace to us and to all Israel, to which we say,
Amen.
Berachat Kohanim.
The priestly blessing is found in Numbers 6, 23-27. Traditionally, the priest blessed the people every morning after the sacrifice at the temple. Today, many synagogues end their service with this blessing as a benediction. In the blessing that follows, the text in brackets is in response to the priest.
V'nismach b'divrei Talmud, Talmud Torah Techa. V'nismach b'divrei Talmud Torah Techa. V'mitzvotecha le'olam va'ed. Ay ay ki heim chayinu v'yorech yaminu uvahem negei yomam v'alayla ki heim chayinu Melech Yaminu, Uvaim Nege Yom Amvalayla. Na 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 na. Ay ay ki heim chayinu v'yorech yaminu uvahem negei yom avalayla. Ki heim chayinu v'yorech yaminu uvahem negei yom avalayla. Na 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 na